in this evening's video, or morning, or night, or mid-afternoon, or whatever it is where you are right now, we're going to be getting into a case of test equipment once again. Now, if you didn't watch the last video, then you don't know what's coming up, but if you did watch the last video, then you will know what we're going to be digging out that case of test equipment. And also, the other thing that you will know is that what we're just about to discuss is the last thing in that case of test equipment. Okay, so let's have a look at it right now then. There it is. Yes, it is that Q-Tech bag. And inside that bag, I'm not sure you can see these marks on here, but that means it's a bit bulged out, and that basically means that not only have I got a bit more in there than what it was when I originally purchased it, but it also means that I've stuffed a bit more in there than what it can take, and so it's a bit bulged out. And because of that, I do have other bits of test equipment, which, really speaking, they should be in there, but there's just no space for them. So I've had to leave them aside, you know, outside of the Q-Tech bag, and just put them in the case of test equipment. And two of the four things that can't go in there includes a couple of volt sticks. So we'll be looking at those, and some homemade test leads. Okay, so what I'm going to be doing for that case is, because of the amount of stuff that's in there, I'm going to do like a two-parter on this. Okay, this is going to be Q-Tech bag number one, and then there's going to be Q-Tech bag number two. Okay, so depending on which one you're watching, there will be a link in the video description to the other part. Okay, so let's get the camera a bit closer then. And I'll open the bag up. We'll have a look around in there. Alright, that can go just down there like that, even though you can see the shadow of the camera. Alright, so let's open it up very carefully then. Actually, I am going to have to tilt that camera up a bit, because that's the angle's a bit too much there. Right, let's open the case up then. There it is. Now you probably noticed as soon as I opened that, there's another thing in it that says Q-Tech on it. Okay. Now, I do have two of these. I've already done a video on one, so I could probably put a link in the description to that. Let's just open it up anyway, just to, you know, so you don't have to click away from this one and then come back. Okay, yes, it's the Q-Tech Lightmates. Okay, it's all five of them in there. And the other one, the other video that I done was not of these, because like I say, I've got two sets of these. It was another set. And I've already done a video on that. So if you want to see those, then, you know, at the end of this video, you can, you know, click the link in the video description. If I remember to put it in, then you can go watch that. Or you can go to the Test Time playlist and look up Q-Tech Lightmates. Or, again, if you go to the video description, there's not a link in there, just give us a polite poke in the comments box, and I shall add it in. Right, there's a whole variety of things in there, which, if I pick the camera up, you can see in there. And, yeah, you know, there's wires in there, blue plug. Some of it's homemade, and some of it's is what you'd buy in, you know, in a shop that sells test equipment. Some of it was in there when I purchased the actual pouch, and some of it was purchased later on and then added in there. Okay, so depending on what part you're about to watch, some of the parts in there will now disappear, and if it's like the shop bought stuff, then you're watching part one. And if it's like the homemade stuff, these wires and things like this, then you are watching part two. I'll just put that in there. seal that up. And into it we go. Righty-o then. You are watching part one of that Q-Tech bag, okay? Let's unzip it and have a look in there. If I can find a zip. There we are then. So, at the front there we've got that. And as introduced, as shown in the introducer section, you know what's in there. Where links in the video description and all of that. So I should just put that over the back. There it is. Now, what have we got left in the case then? Like I say, there are bits of kit in there which were in there when I purchased it. And there are other bits of kit in there which I've purchased later on and then added in there myself. To start off with then, what I'm going to do is we'll just have a look at these bolt sticks. Okay, so we've got this one and then this one. Okay, let's put them down there on the floor and have a look at them. Right, first off then, we got this Volt Alert one. Bit of a cheapy one, this, but if you get it near anything which is live with mains voltage on it, like, say, 240 volts or something, the idea is this end here, it flashes a red colour, and there's also a little bleeper in there as well. So when you get it near a live power cable or a wall socket or something like that, you get a visual alert here, and you get an audible tone as well as an alert. And I have to say, the bleep on that is actually quite loud. The funny thing about this is it's funny and a bit sad at the same time. I don't know if I'll be able to get on it. Okay, I probably will, because this camera's generally very good for zoom. If I zoom in on that. Right, interestingly, camera's got right on that. Up here then, it says, warning, text, before using. Yeah, I think that's supposed to be test before using. So, okay, so they've put an X in test. Before is actually misspelled with two R's instead of an R and an E. And surprisingly, they've actually managed to spell using correctly without putting an E in it. And there we go. So you can tell it's not made in the UK. But then what is these days? So there it is. Warning. Text before using. Oh dear, somewhat rather laughable, isn't it? So there you go. And that is the Volt Alert. It does actually work as well, despite its misspellings on it. There you go then, that is the model number of it. 1AC-A. Sensitivity range is 90 to 1000 volts AC. Double insulated, category 2000 volts. And I suppose, well, I don't know what that is, YH2001. Okay. So there you go. Text before using, don't forget that. In case you're wondering what that is, I don't know why, but that doesn't work when you've got rechargeable batteries in this. But in the front, there's a little LED in there. If I can press this and give this a twiddle, there you go. There's a little light in the front of that. And that button on the front of there, you're supposed to press that. Well, supposed to be able to press that, and the little light illuminates. Okay, that can be handy sometimes inside, you know, a dark cupboard or whatnot. To open up the cupboard and you're looking for electric cables to get this near to see if they're live, you can push the little button and it lights up inside the cupboard. But I'm pressing that, and although I've got rechargeable batteries in there, it doesn't actually put out any light. Okay, even if I fully recharge the rechargeable batteries. You press that and it just barely lights up. Okay. Keeping in mind that most rechargeable batteries are 1.2 volts and your disposable batteries are 1.5 volts, yeah, you are missing out on quite a bit of, well, not, I wouldn't say quite a bit of voltage, but you're losing at least half a volt on that by using rechargeable batteries. So I generally don't use that, you just use a standard flicking torch for goodness sake. But there we are. So that's volt stick number one then. What about the other one? Is it a bit better? Well, let's put it to you this way. This one's it. They claim it's to be made by Q-Tech. Okay, this is a Q-Stick one. Rather much like the other one. You got like the tip here at the end. When you get it near live power cable, wiring accessory, whatever, it illuminates red. Okay. I did actually have an issue with this some time back. I had batteries in it, and I opened up the case of test equipment just to get my one of my testers out, and this thing, it was just glowing inside the case. I couldn't turn it off. I couldn't do anything with it. There isn't a switch on it. Okay, you can't turn it on or off. Okay, that's up. Really speaking, that is the whole idea, because if it did have a switch on it and you turned it off, and then you've got this near live power supply and it didn't light up, you'd think, well, yeah, the power's off. But then, really speaking, you should not use one of these to verify the absence of power, because one of the flaws that can go wrong with one of these is the batteries could wear out. Okay, so if you rely on one of these for detecting mains voltage, then do not do it. Okay, because like I say, if the batteries are never worn out and you get that near a cable that so happens to be live, you will not get any indication that it is live. And yes, the next thing that could happen is you getting roasted. So on there it says double insulated, 100 600 volts AC. Is that going to get on that, or do I have to use manual again? What? There we go. So 100 to 600 volts AC, category 3, 600 volts AC. Okay, it's Q-Tech, Q-Stick 1. And it says lift capped to replace batteries, and there's a little cap there where you put the batteries in. But yeah, I did once have an issue with this where I got it out the case of test equipment, and it was just glowing continuously. Whether that's an error mode just to say that the batteries are running low, I don't know. But so I took the batteries out, chucked them, and I haven't used that since. Funnily enough, whenever I do need a volt stick, I'll go for this one, because not only have you got the where it lights up, but you've also got an audible tone on it as well. Okay, so there we are, two volt sticks then. What we're going to do now is just break off. You can nip off and have a cup of tea time, and when we come back, we're going to be having a look at more of the things that are inside this case of little Q-Tech case. Okay, so just bear with me a moment, and we'll come back after this. Okay then, we're back after the break, and what we're going to be doing now is we're going to be carrying on cutting into that case of bits and pieces that says Q-Tech on it. Okay, so let's do that now, and just coming into focus then, there's it all is. I will zoom out a bit and then let's get into it. Now, in the first section, I said that when I purchased the case, there were bits and pieces in there already that comes with it, and there were certain bits and pieces which I purchased at a later date and put in there. From what I can remember, it was this which I purchased as an optional extra, and that. So I'm going to take those out just for the meanwhile. We'll be discussing those next, and I do believe that what we've got there then, including the light mates, I believe it was called something like ACC Kit 1. And what you got in the kit was obviously the case for all to go in. You got these set of jump leads. Okay. I think there's like four of them in there. Two of them are really short and two of them are quite long. So you get those in there. The pad adapter one. Okay. I'll be getting everything out of the case. Don't worry about that. The pad adapter one. I've forgotten what that's called now. Q-Check R2, I believe that's called. This funny little padlock. The light mates, and there's a couple of like tags in here somewhere. Now, what these are for is when you've locked off a circuit breaker or whatnot, you're supposed to clip this onto that padlock, and obviously speaking, you put your date on there, your contact phone number, who to call, and put your signature on it. But you know, I've never used that. What I plan to do is actually put that in a photocopier, make a few photocopies of it. So there you go. So there you go. Obviously speaking, once you've written on that, you've ruined it. So there you are. There's two of those in the pouch. Here's the other one. Okay. So that's what comes in with the ACC kit one, I believe. You get light mates, two of those, pad adapter one, the Q-Check R2, the little locking off padlock, which is a combination type, and the jump leads. Okay, they're like little crocodile clips inside there. Okay, like I say, two short ones and two long ones. And there we go. So, what about the optional bits of kit that I purchased at a later date and added in there? Well, the first one, it's got plug pins on it. Now, these are available everywhere in a whole variety of different brands and whatnot. This is just a quickie checker. I got a feeling, actually, I got this as part of a kit of something else. I've got a feeling it was my CombiVolt 2. Because when I purchased the CombiVolt 2, I did actually get a couple of other things thrown in with it, and I got a feeling it was this and this cheapy volt stick. Okay. I don't even know now, actually, if you get the Q-Stick 1 with the ACC kit 1. I do believe you do, so that may actually very well belong in there. But like I said, I don't know why I don't keep that in there. I've got a feeling it's because I'll keep other things on top of the case, and if ever I need this, I've got to get everything out of the case of test equipment, then go into it just to get a flipping volt stick out, so I just don't bother keeping this in that case. So I've got a feeling you do actually get the Q-Stick 1 with the ACC kit 1. But anyway, I got this, like I say, I think it was bundled in with the CombiVolt 2 because it's a dialogue. Okay. Now what this is for is you just put that in the wall socket, switch it on, and you get a sequence of lights show up on there. Okay. And it's one of these ones. This has also got a bleeper in it as well. Okay. There you go, it says the sequence of lights on the front of that then. If I can get all that stuff off the screen, I can see it, you can see it, and everyone else can see it. There we go. So then, up the top, right at the top here, we've got two greens and a red. Okay. There's your model number, DL1090, I believe. So the one, when you plug this in, the one that you want is the two green ones lit up and not the red one, and that's correct. Okay, if you just get one green one and the two other ones are out, then you've got a missing earth connection. Okay, that one could be slightly worrying. Okay, the live conductor and the earth conductor in the back of the socket are around the wrong way, which basically means if you plug anything in that socket that's got a metal case, then the metal casing on that appliance is going to be up at mains voltage, which is a bit scary. Then the next one down, you've got when the green one's on, the red one's on. Live neutral reverse. Okay, so basically a polarity screwed up then. Okay, and if you just get a green one light up down the bottom, there's a missing neutral. Now, I don't know what happened to the little case that is coming. It obviously was in one of those like retail type blister packets. You've got to cut it open with a pair of scissors, but there was a card in there, and it shows on that card all of these and a whole pile of others. But these are probably the most referred to ones, so they've actually put them on the front here. I'm just a bit worried about that live earth reverse one though. Okay. It's a bit scary that, because you think, well, why is the socket not working? And you plug something in here like a washing machine or a fridge or a tumble dryer or something, and when you go and touch it to turn it on, you get a blast up your arm. That could be a bit scary, that one. So, yeah. But like I say, the thing with these, all it does is just tell you that the wires are in the correct place in the back of the socket. It does not tell you how good that wiring is, and that's the reason why you need a proper tester that, you know, you can do various different tests whether the socket be live or dead, and you'll be able to then determine that the wiring is okay in the back. Okay, a dead test will obviously be like continuity and polarity, and your live tests are things be things like PSCC and that sort of stuff. This doesn't do any of that. You just shove it in the socket. It isn't even got a switch on it. You just shove it in there, and yeah, it'll tell you that the wires are in the right place in the back of the socket. And, you know, so there it is. Now, before I show the next bit of kit that I purchased as an optional extra, I'm just going to put that down there. There's this. This is included in with the ACC kit one, and it's a wall socket test probe terminal. Now, I've already done a video on one of these. I've got two of these. This is the second one, because it came with the ACC kit one. And well, basically what you do with it is you get your test leads from, you know, a testing meter or whatnot, put them in the respective holes, and then connect it in the wall socket. Okay, this can be used, depending on the tester you connect into it, it can be used to tell you polarity of the socket, what the voltage is in the socket. You can, you know, thump the socket with a PSCC test, earth fault loop test, or even an RCD test. There's a whole variety of tests you can do with this and a tester, depending on the tester you connect into it. Okay, so there you go. Just to cover it then, this will be your neutral. Okay, and you put your blue probe in there, or your black one. This one's your live active phase hot, call it what you like. You put your red probe in there, or your black red probe in there, or your brown one, and the one up the top is your earth conductor. Okay, so you put your green one in there. Okay, and then you just put that in a 13 amp socket. That's the pin configuration on the back of that. Okay, so the reason why I showed this first instead of the optional one is to do with this. Okay, there you go. It's another one. So they look the same that way, but as you can see, I've got hold of the top of this one, and the reason why, if I'll just tilt that camera down a bit, I'll keep you guessing. This one has got a cable coming out the top of it. Okay, there's a very good reason for that. With this one, you haven't got a choice. It's a 13 amp plug on the back of it. Okay. With this one, you get that, there's nothing on the back, and there's a wire that comes out, and then you can put a plug of your choice on the other end. Now, I'm going to explain why I've put that on there a little bit later, but if you want to buy one of these that's got the wire coming out of it, because you think, well, yeah, you know, that's a good idea, where you can put your test probes in and then connect it in a socket, and that makes a nice safe connection instead of stuffing the test probes straight in the wall socket, which is a bit dodgy. And you'll probably find in the UK that you have a bit of a challenge doing that, because our sockets have got shutters in them. Okay, so you got this instead. You put your test probes in there, straight in the wall socket, nice safe connection. But you might want to test a 15 amp round pin socket, and that is just not going to go in there. Well, that is what this can be used for. Okay, put your test probes in there, and then on the other end of that, you wire a 15 amp round pin plug on that, and you're good to go. Or you could have a 16 amp plug on that, one of those blue plugs. I do have one handy here. Like this, okay. You can put that on the end of there if you want, but here's the problem, okay. You got your test probe terminal there, length of wire, and once you've put a particular plug on the end of that, that's it, okay. So you'd have to, buy one of these and put a 15 amp plug on it. And you'd have to buy another one and put one of those blue plugs on there. And you'd have to buy another one and put the 110 volt yellow plug on the end of there. Well, stuff that. This is Wayne's Electrical, and I've got a better idea. Okay, I'll put that on the end of it. Okay, and into there I can then connect. That blue plug I've just shown? That'll connect on there, and then I've got a blue plug on there. I can connect on there. I think I've got a 15 amp plug floating around somewhere. I can connect that on there. So by putting that on, I can choose what goes on the end of that, and I only need to buy one of them, okay? Because I seriously have the flavour, and that is how I've delivered it in this one. This model numbers then, that's a Q-Check R2. I'll just get on that for you. Okay, that says it there then, Q-Check R2, and the other one is a Q-Check R2 FL. Now the FL basically means a flying lead. Okay. So like I say, if you were thinking, yeah, that's a good idea, if you were thinking that's a good idea, but you want to test something other than a 13 amp socket, you need the Q-Check R2 FL, and that's then got a lead on it, and you can put a plug of your choice on the end of it. So there we go. Right, fancy a break, cup of tea time, maybe grab a snack? I think so. We'll carry on after the break then. Here we are then, we're back. We're going to be carrying on with that case then, and let's get into it, no messing about. The Q-Tech Lightmates then. I've already done a video on these because I've got two sets of these. All they basically are is, well, we just talked about these. We put your test probes in and connect it in the wall socket. How about something like this, but instead of connecting into a wall socket, you can connect it into a light fitting. Yes, that's what these are for. There you go, Edison screw on there. Two holes for putting your test probes in. Need I say any more? You get ones like that. That's E27 on there. You can get BC22, SBC, SES, small Edison screw. You can even get GU10, because there they all are in the pouch. If you want a more in-detailed video of these, then yes, do press the link in the video description, or if it's not in there, you can dive into the test time playlist and search for Q-Tech Lightmates and you will find it. So that's those done then. Next up, these little bag of what are they called? Jump leads. Let's get them all out. Like I say, there's two short ones and two long ones in there. There's the short ones. Okay, not too long at all. Let me get all the others out of the way and you'll be able to see it. There it is. Okay, not too long at all. Now, what would you use that for then? Well, under certain tests, there are certain connections. Let's say, for example, inside a consumer unit, you might want to join them together. Okay, when you're doing a dead test, you might want to say join the neutral and the face bus bars together, or the neutral and the earth bus bars, and they might be right next to each other. And having a test lead which is half a mile long could add resistance into your test readings. So, you know, you don't need something that long. So, just a little wee short one, just to join the neutral and the earth bus bars together while you go around and test the ring circuit at various different sockets. That's ideal for that. I've got like little crocodile clip type things in there. I'm pretty sure if I can push that through, make that stick out a bit further, so you can get it onto the bus bars. But I've got a feeling that's what that's for. There you go, you can pull the crocodile clips out so that you can get it onto the bus bar. So you can actually slide that back in a bit like that. You can fully access the jaws. Okay, I would seem to think you wouldn't use these in the live situation, because with the danger there being, if this was on a live bus bar and one of them dropped off, you go and grab that to put it back on wherever it was, and you can touch that and get a blast off it or whatnot. But then, having said that, you shouldn't have a consumer unit open while it's live. You should switch it off. Okay, so you'd use these in dead tests only, and there's two of them. Where's the other one? There's the other one. The two little short jump leads then. And in case the bus bars are a bit further apart, you've got this one which is really long. I'll put that there. There you go, you can see that there. That's the really long one then. Okay, and there's two of those as well. So that's the little set of jump leads. And, I'm pretty sure if you went on the Q-Tech website, they've got a order code for these. So if you think, oh, that's a really useful idea, that for testing inside a consumer unit or wherever you need to join two terminals together for testing purposes, dead test, mind you, that's what these are for. They're in there. You get them as part of the ACC Kit 1. I'm just going to rebag those then. And then, if I can remember the combination to that padlock, I'm going to take it off and we'll have a little talk about that. I'll do that off camera. Right. Little padlock then. So what's that used for? Funny little padlock. Well, during testing purposes, or you know, when you need to isolate an electricity supply and then test it, there is a procedure for doing that, you know. And you don't just, you know, turn switch off and walk off, you know. There is a certain procedure for it. And that little padlock there allows you to do that procedure, because you know, you've got to lock it off. I will get my words out. Safe isolation procedure. Okay, that is what that's for. Let's see if I can remember the combination of. Chances are I've just put it on zero or something. There you go, I've managed to release it then. So we'll just lock it back up. I'll just scramble it. I'm not showing you what my access code is. Right, there it is then, little padlock. And we'll just shove that aside. Little locking off padlock then. Okay. You could use this for a variety of things. You can use it for, on an isolator, where you've got the hole for putting the padlock on. That's why you've got a shackle on the top of it. And this funny sort of thing on the side here, and you've got a little point here and this screw thread thing, that is so you can lock it onto the toggle switch for an MCB. And the way that works is down the side there, you've got your access code. Okay, there's your access code then. You dial in your access code, you open it up. I will just do that now. Right, padlock is open then. You turn that. You fit it onto the MCB, and then this little part here, it rotates. And then there's a little pin that comes out of there. I will rotate it. See that pin that's coming out? Well, that would grip onto the toggle of the MCB. And because you've got like these three little cutout sections here, you'd be able to rotate that around so that it opens that hole up. So you can turn the shackle around and lock it up like so. Okay. And once that's in then you've locked it. Let me just lock the padlock up. There you go. You cannot rotate that now. So that would then be locked onto the MCB. And the idea being, because you only know the access code, it's only you that can take it off. And then when that's on the MCB, you're supposed to hang that on the shackle, and it says that on it. Okay. And that's what that is, so you can carry out the safe isolation procedure. And then once you're done, and then put your access code in, open it, twiddle that, give that a twist. It then opens that part up down there, so you can take it off the circuit breaker. Okay, so we'll just twizzle that back in. The little padlock does actually say Q-Tech on it. Right, there it is then. Yeah, it does actually say Q-Tech on it. Just about there, sort of thing. There you go, you can see that. If I can see that on the silly little screen on the side of the camera, I'm pretty sure you can see that in full eye definition on your computer screen. Okay, so there's a locking off padlock. We're almost done. What about this then? The PAT adapter 1. So what is it? It's got a socket outlet on the front of it. What is it and what can you do with it? Or for that matter, disappointingly, what you cannot do with it. In a way, I'm not saying that that was the sole reason for me purchasing the ACC Kit 1, but I kind of figured that would be a useful tool for doing PAT testing. And yeah, I got it out of the box, took a look at it. Yeah, okay then. And well, I was a bit disappointed with it. Okay, if you know how to do a three-way test on an extension lead, then fine. You know, you test the live conductor, the neutral conductor, the earth conductor, and then when you do an insulation resistance test, you obviously put, the test current. One would be live to neutral, the other one would be neutral to earth, and then live to earth. Okay, but you cannot do that with that one, and I'll tell you why. If I just go back to this, you'll see that this has got three holes for putting your test probes in. It's that Q-Check again, Q-Check R2. So you've got three holes, three places for putting your test probes in. But on this, bit of a problem for the more advanced tester like myself. But for the rookie, you know, this is why they've had to design it in this way, because, you know, Q-Check have had to protect themselves from dollards on the basis that anyone can purchase one of these, no questions asked. You can go on a really well-known auctioning website and just buy one. Okay, you don't have to have, you know, any qualification or prove it or anything like that. You just go buy one. And that's where, you know, if they didn't design it in the way that they have, then it would cause problems, because you'd be able to, like say, connect a sensitive bit of electronics in there, ran 500 volts into it from an insulation resistance tester and pop it. And that would cause all sorts of hoo-ha, wouldn't it? So what they've done then is where you put the test probes into this thing is there's only two holes. Oh dear. So what's happening there then? Well, one of these holes, I can't remember which one, it goes to the top hole for the earthing conductor. And the other hole on the top of it, it goes to both of these down the bottom. Okay, so these are basically bridged inside, and you cannot detach that bridge. You don't put batteries in this thing. Okay, it's just two test probe holes on the top, and a place for putting in a 13-amp plug. That's basically it. Okay, so, you know, you can't do continuity with it. Okay, if you think, well, why is that appliance not working? Let's say, for example, a hairdryer. This will tell you nothing about the hairdryer. You can't just plug a hairdryer in there, put a continuity test current in one and get it out the other and think, well, Right, then the switch on here dries off, or the fuse and the plug has blown, something like that. And I do need to point out for my international viewers that we do have fuses in the plugs in the UK. Okay, so yes, it won't tell you any of that, you know, and that's disappointing. But like I say, Q-Tech have had to design it like that just to protect themselves from dollards, because like I say, if you could put 500 volts into this thing, connect a bit of sensitive electronics in there, and that 500 volts happened to be across there and there, these two holes down the bottom, something's going to go bang and something's going to get sued sooner or later. So yes, you know, just to protect, you know, Q-Tech to protect themselves from the dollards, they've only put two holes on the top. One, like I say, goes to the earth pin on the up top, and the other one goes to the two down the bottom here. And yes, when you do an insulation resistance test, you can only do the insulation resistance test between the earth and both of the conductors down the bottom here. Okay, you cannot, like I say, for example, on an extension lead, do the live to neutral insulation resistance test, just test the insulation on the live and neutral conductors. You can't do that because this won't let you do it, which is very disappointing. And my little top tip there is, if you're doing an insulation resistance test on an extension lead, make sure you don't touch the plug on the end, and connect one of these into the outlet on the other end of the trailing socket. Put your relevant test leads across there, whack it up to 500 volts and stab the button, and that'll get you out of that problem. Okay, it's just that you have to make sure not to touch those. Put that in the extension lead before pressing the button, and the plug on the other end of the extension lead, just don't touch it, just keep away from it. And you know, you can get a insulation resistance test done on an extension lead that way. Don't let that get in your way. I've used that, I think, about once or twice, and I've just shoved it back in that pouch and forgotten about it because of that on the top. Ideal for a little rookie or somebody who wants to do a quick bit of pack testing, but for the more advanced, you know, like myself, nah, disappointed with that, really am. But like I say, Q-Tech have actually designed it like that because, you know, to protect themselves from dollards. So, what we've been looking at in this video then? Well, we've been looking at volt sticks, disappointing pad adapter, locking off padlock, the little lockout tags, I don't know what I'd want to call that, socket tester? You know, you just put it in the socket and it just says to you that the wires in the back of the socket are in the right place. It don't tell me how good the connections are. Again, I've already done a video on one of these, but I've covered it in this video again anyway. The Q-Check R2. And of course, that really interesting Q-Check R2 FL. With you put a plug of your choice on the end of that. I've opted for that. And of course, the jump leads in there. And I've just quickly covered them, because I've already done a video on them, and that is the Q-Tech Light Mates.